Man, are you serious? This motherfucker is fly.
Glad you like it. As I told you, it's yours.
Are you seriously serious?
For the fifth time, yes. But I gotta go. I'll be in touch about our little venture.
Man, good looking. Yeah. This motherfucker. Woo!
Well, I'll use this opportunity. Hello and welcome again to another episode of Grand Theft Auto 5. I can't say it correctly. Anyways, doesn't matter. Yeah, new episode. So let's try and get into it. Oh, I remember that. Club has its own area. How much money do we have? Thousands. Okay. Yeah, get fucked, you stupid bitch. yeah. No. You guys can't even listen to it, so I'll just keep it off. If the viewers can't hear it, then neither should I. Come on, fucking hell. The cars. Ah, there they are. Oh shit. Not good. Oh shit. Now I hope climate change kills you. That's terrible.
Okay, you know Redwood cigarettes?
Sure, the cigarette that built America.
They've rigged a jury to throw a class action lawsuit that would cover the treatment costs of thousands of emphysema sufferers. There are four corrupt jurors on Redwood's books. I'll send you the details. Oh, and we only have a few hours to make them disappear. The court case is tomorrow morning.
Is that all, dog? Shit, that's quite a favor.
And that's quite a house you're living in. Get this done quickly, and I'll try to throw in a sweetener as well. Now, I'd advise picking up some long-range hardware to get this job done. You'll be helping a lot of people with this, Franklin, including anyone who might have a sizable investment in, say, debonair cigarettes.
Hmm. Does anyone even ever, delete the message? Does anyone ever do that? I don't. I just kill the juror. And then I forget after the mission's done.
What the hell?
Easy. What, you're still alive? Shit!
Get down and lay down. Ain't nothing personal.
How dare they get up when I shoot them for comedy? Easy.
Damn, I ain't got much time left.
We've got plenty of time. Not even difficult.
Hey, L, it's done, homie. All of them.
Very good. I'll be in touch.
That didn't happen. Okay, dude, but who cares?
Ugh.
Are you fucking kidding me? A Christmas tree? It's November!
Look out!
Get out the fucking way!
Dear God. You entitled piece of shit!
Fuck, I forgot this is a Wentle. Shit. Oh, the Wentlers are gonna kill me.
Hey, you selfish prick!
It's already fucked as it is. Solomon. They're fucking us. The suits, and they're not even wearing suits.
You know, I used to have three secretaries. Now I have to make my own coffee and give myself a happy ending. See, the ships are coming in, but the walls will hold us.
Nelson in Naples.
Pluto? I said Mars, you cocksucker.
Shoulder of Orion. Two.
Devin Weston said you were a fan.
Huge fan.
Tell me, Michael. Devin Weston. Does he want you to bump me off?
No, not at all. He said you were retiring but might need some help on a movie.
Only assholes retire, Michael. Him and my son, they want to put me out to pasture so they can turn this place into condos or a theme park or something.
But this place is a dream factory.
Well, maybe they have different dreams. Some days, I don't blame them. You know, they always say, never work with children or animals. Well, I want to add to that list. Never work with directors or actors. This picture is going to kill me.
All right. So what's it about?
It's perfect. Set in Liberty City. Meltdown. It's all being shot on green screen right out back there. We take a look at the financial crisis, and then we boil it all down into a really simplistic battle between two yuppies. Lots of training montages.
So what's the problem?
Milton McElroy. I cast him in the second lead because he's cheap. Zero talent, incidentally. Well, he's got this new agent, Rocco Pelosi. He's been hassling us about renegotiating the deal. So now, he's holding up shooting until he gets paid.
That sounds problematic.
It would be if the director wanted to shoot. Anton Baudelaire. Ever heard of him? That doesn't surprise me. Now he's having a mental breakdown, pissing all over himself who knows where.
All right. Looks like you got yourself that new assistant. But no happy endings.
I love you already.
Yay, we get to fuck someone over!
Coming this weekend!
Hey, Solomon. I'm just doing that thing.
Good, good. Now, I realized in my excitement, I forgot some details.
Yeah, it seemed obvious. You want this Pelosi guy clipped.
No, God, no. Is that an option? No, no, no. Bad idea, bad idea. No clipping anyone. Just teach him some manners. He's also in my director's ear as well, if you'd believe it. So teach this punk a lesson and bring the talent back to set. Ideally, in a more collaborative mood.
I'll see what I can do. They all gonna be at the club?
I'm told it isn't a club so much as a rat pit. Anton and Milton are supposed to be there, and Pelosi's on the way to pick them up. He's taking them to his lawyer to sign the contracts. So if he hears there's someone from the studio coming, he'll get him out fast.
All right. I'll go in quiet. I'll see you on the set, boss.
That building looks like shit. This is too easy. Too fucking easy.
There you are! Mr. Richards has been worried sick.
Oh, who's this?
Who's this jackass?
Hey, you!
Oh, turns out these guys are in love with their contract. There's nothing going back to the set with me.
Can you believe this fucking clown? No! This guy's all mine!
Come on, come on, come on.
I'll go easy, old man.
Yeah.
We're gonna make a new deal. You leave my people alone, and I don't toss you off this roof.
Yeah, Okay? Sure, man, sure.
Alright. Let's get back to the lot.
Yeah, one, you fuckhead.
Whoa, hey!
Shut up.
Look, you can bully him, but you can't bully Talent, buddy. We are not shooting until I get a new deal.
Can't bully Talent? Just watch me. You're gonna be a good boy when I'm done.
I don't see talent at all.
I don't know who you think you are. Jumped up studio security?
I ain't security. I'm Solomon's assistant.
I should never have left that track den this morning.
Shit! I drove way too sporadically than needed. Fuck.
Just hold on.
Look, you can bully him, but you can't bully Talent, buddy. We are not shooting until I get a new deal.
Can't bully Talent? Just watch me. You're gonna be a good boy when I'm done.
I don't know who you think you are. Jumped up to assist. Jesus Christ, man! You know who you got in here? Just fucking slow down!
Maybe they don't like to be up high. You can either apologize, or we can go and have a fly in the helicopter again.
Look, I'm feeling a little keyed up. How about I call my guy, go on a little jolly, and call Solomon from wherever I wake up in a week?
How about you see him right now, and we go flying again if you even look like you fail a piss test at any point on this shoot?
Yeah, learn your place, motherfuckers.
What a wonderful surprise. Anton, my boy, you're an artist, I know that. And this story is the best kind of art. A simplistic, cliche-ridden pile of dross that you will turn into magic. Get a grip, I love ya.
So Solomon, Milton here has a little something he wants to say to you. Say it.
I just want to say that I'm sorry for any misunderstanding, sir. And I appreciate all the opportunities that...
Michael, what can I say? You're a natural. I love you.
You're too kind.
No, I mean it. I don't mean to presume. But would it be okay if I gave you a shout? This shoot seems cursed for some reason or another. I need an associate producer.
I'd love that.
We'll talk soon. I gotta go.
Oh, hell yeah.
A happy ending. Oh my god! Oh, that car is awesome. I've gotta have it. I gotta bring it. Ah, shit.
Ah, this is total bullshit.
This is a good fucking car. Old vintage car. Jackpot.
Anyone home?
Of course not. Alright, that's gonna be the end of this episode. Hope you guys enjoyed. Make sure to like and subscribe if you did. Bye bye.